Mr. President, if you're a conference, I think we must refer substitute House Bill 1, last night, 5, for Representative Sons. I'm sorry, as a message from the conference committee, not a message from the House, excuse me. Senator Deborah.
Thank you, Mr. President. I move that the conference committee report for substitute House Bill 1155 be held action.
Senator Deborah's move that the conference report for substitute House Bill 1155 be adopted at large. Senator Deborah.
Thank you, Mr. President. The committee did meet, and what was done is we renewed the 8-hour workday. And what the bill now does is clarifies that if a respite is interrupted by an employer, that the employee is given additional attendance. It delays the implementation of the respite provision and the overtime provision for hospitals that are certified as critical access hospitals, or hospitals that are fewer than 25, have fewer than 25 acute care beds in operations, and hospitals that are certified as sole community hospitals for 2 years. So it really makes sure that we are taking care of the care of people who take care of us when we're in the hospital. It ensures that hospitals that may have a hard time trying to modify their current practice or accommodate this new law, but give them the time that they need in order to get that done. I do want to thank the hospitals and the nurses for working together on language that can work for both parties. And the important thing here to remember is that our healthcare workers, our hospitals, they're all in business to ensure that they are taking care of people. It is at the end of the day our patient care. And we have to make sure that we're taking care of the people that are taking care of our patients. And this bill gets us there. So I urge adoption of the conference committee report.
Further remarks, Senator King.
Thank you, Mr. President. Well, we did meet. I would say that beyond taking out the 8 hours, we also removed the amendment that was in the bill that we hung. It was my amendment that had removed critical access hospitals and hospitals and 25 beds or less from this requirement. Obviously, that was removed, and therefore, I did not sign on to this report and would ask the body to reject it. These are all negotiated items, and now we're doing the work that the hospitals and the union should have. They couldn't do it together, so the unions come to us and say, "Hey, take care of it." So here we are, taking care of it. Thank you, Mr. President.
Further remarks, Senator Allen.
Thank you, Mr. President. While I do have some concerns in the bill, that's not what I want to speak on right now. I do want to point out for consideration by my good friends on the other side of the aisle the fact that we really need joint rules. In the way this conference committee was processed, I think emphasizes that point. I had not planned on attending the conference committee because I wasn't a member or conferee. And then I saw the notice. The notice sent out gave about, 7 to 10 minutes notice of when the meeting was going to take inappropriate. And again, I'm sorry that this bill is before us. I'm sorry that the staffing, nurse staffing committees that became effective in January of this year haven't even been given a chance to work. This is way too much overreach on our part. We have no right telling hospitals how to care for their patients, and I'm very sorry I have to be a strong no on this bill today.
Further remarks? Senator Saldana.
Thank you, Mr. President, and I will rise in support of what we have before us, 1155, because what it states is that however we're a nurse is caring for their patients, they deserve to have clarity and consistent regular breaks for the patient so that they are sustained to be able to come back and do their work through their shifts. What is clear and that we're not doing today is we're not telling the hospitals how they must have their ratios or how many of their nurses or what capacity that they will be able to make sure that nurses have their breaks. We are actually encouraging them to use the committees that they have formed between the nurses and managers and the hospital managers to make sure that each hospital will be able to figure out how that works best, but with the actual workers at the committee making those decisions. But what we're saying is that it's not okay for them to continue to have continued interruptions and not having that safety and making sure that there's actually always that we actually have the care that patients deserve and that these workers deserve to have the respect. They worked hard to be able to get to become nurses. It is not an easy job. If you know nurses, you know how hard they fought to be able to make sure that they could get those grades, because they have to keep a certain grade point average throughout their whole time while they're becoming nurses. And then once they're nurses, you know, they're seeing us at our worst. When we are most in need, and to make sure that they actually have those breaks. So that's why we're supporting this bill. It doesn't mean that it has to look the same, but it's making sure that everyone has their breaks. And I do commend and hope that we can learn more today.
Further remarks? Senator Eifert.
Thank you, Mr. President. I'm urging a no vote on this piece of legislation. I spoke to a hospital administrator of a very small hospital in my district. He said right now,
Mr. President, there are 32 DA 16 candidates.
Thanks, Mr. Chairman. Jury substitute House.